Today on The Brief, everyone loves USB drives. They are, after all, a really convenient way to back up and move files from machine to machine, a relatively high-capacity, high-speed form of the sneaker net that dominated computing's early years. I've got tons of them, and I use them all the time, and I'm pretty sure you do too. But it's time for USB drives to die. Recently, a Chinese national, Yuxing Zhang, went to Mar-a-Lago, Donald Trump's private resort in Florida. She was carrying a laptop, four smartphones, an external hard drive, some cash, a signal detector capable of spotting hidden cameras, and a USB thumb drive. She said she wanted to meet the American president. The Secret Service smelled a rat and arrested her. What's disturbing is what happened after she was detained. One of the agents stuck her USB drive into a laptop to analyze it, where it immediately began installing files on the machine. The agent quickly aborted the analysis, and the Secret Service still won't say what was on the drive or if their machine, or worse, the network, was corrupted. This case sends chills down the spine of anyone who's responsible for IT security. Like floppy disks and CDs and DVDs before them, USB drives now represent the soft underbelly of security. If you're looking for a ridiculously easy way to either steal information outright or plant malware in a place where it can do major damage, thumb drives are an efficient, effective means of pulling it off. The investigation into the Florida case is, of course, still ongoing. It could simply be a naive superfan with more enthusiasm than brains. Or it could be something more sinister. Time will tell. But IT still needs to move quickly to close that giant yawning security gap represented by allowing anyone to use any USB drive on any device within the corporate network. Don't just think you can flip on BitLocker or simply block USB ports and call it done. Your strategy needs a rethink, and we've got the analysts who can help you build it. Feel free to give us a call. That's food for thought.